As a reporter who covers SpaceX for, many years, we're all kind of used to them kind of pushing the envelope and really pulling off these amazing feats of engineering. But I have to say, this really took things up a notch. I think there was a lot of skepticism going into this about whether or not it would be successful because, I mean, you look at it and it does look surreal, right? It's catching this massive booster in midair using these grid fins that are so small in comparison to the booster itself. But, and I think when they first had talked about it, I was definitely very curious to see how it would play out, but it worked exactly as designed. And so, you have to hand it to them. It was a pretty spectacular feat.
Yeah, really cool stuff. But why do they explain why they tested this, why they have to do this? Because anyone familiar with the way that SpaceX lands boosters, at least for other rockets, they do this on barges. They can land kind of anywhere. Why do they need to catch this in midair?
Yeah, so for them, I think it was just more about how it was designed, and it was easier for them not to put landing legs on the booster. So for the Falcon 9, they have landing legs that deploy, and that allows them to land that way. But with this, the idea is that, the launch tower will catch these boosters, lower them down to the launch mount. So they're basically back where they started. They refuel them, put a new ship on
Wow.
top, and then, launch it again. And so that's kind of the idea behind this, is to be rapidly reusable and fully reusable, which is supposed to, allow them to move much more quickly and to bring down the launch costs. If you remember, Falcon 9s are technically reusable, but they're only partly reusable because their upper stages or top portions don't return to Earth. So this would be a bit of a game changer if they can get the full thing to be reused and then turn around, super quickly.
Okay, so now Elon can go to Mars. Well, not yet.
I don't know if
So,
he's in
but
line.
not
I
so
think he's
simple.
like.
But this is part of the process, right? Or this is part of his grand scheme.
Yeah, this was definitely a milestone that they really needed to achieve in order to get to that ultimate goal, right? Because one of the main things that Starship is going to have to do is refuel in orbit. So essentially, they'll have to launch Starship to orbit and then launch a bunch more times back to back, sending tankers to that Starship to fuel it up. And that's going to require, it could be dozens of launches, up to a dozen or so. We still don't know the exact number. And that's just to reach the moon, to have enough fuel to reach the moon. So they're going to have to be able to launch back to back in a really relatively short time frame. And so being able to return the booster, fill it up quickly, and then launch it again quickly, that's going to be essential in order for pulling off these deep space missions.